Good morning, everyone. If you're watching this right now, welcome back to the Minecraft GM episodes. Finally, we are now going to go on to the verge of completing the final and the last trial of the seventh. Greek locations. So, you're ready. Hit that subscribe button to see this channel grow. And also hit that bell notification or smack it if you can. It really, really does help. Thank you if you did it right now. That's awesome. Good. Congratulations, because that does help. All right. Now, before we move on, I did a little few things off screen during the time I was taking a break from the trials here. My friend, however, is frequently coming here to set up another map for me. So, with that map, however, could be different than what you're familiar with. So once it's finished, my friend will let me know. So keep an eye out for updates on that. The first thing on our to-do list before we, continue on from here, guess what? My wings on my person here is not functioning correctly, so I'm able to fly in it, however, but it's damaged pretty intensely. So in order to repair it, this anvil right here will allow us to repair that. So we're gonna go and use our get our Elytra here. Place the Elytra in and go place at least 3 or 4 of these. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, see? 4. So it's gonna cost us 4 enchantments just to repair this itself alone. So, in order to maintain the possibility of flight, it's always a good thing to have. However, what I have learned is that you can falter the... falter is not a good word for that. You can alter the rockets. You can use them without having a rocket, a fire star, or whatever you call it. A firecracker star, or whatever you call it, in some way where you can use it without that particular item where it explodes on impact, where it damages you. However, there is a way where you can actually change that, where it just says firework rocket. It doesn't have any coloring, Firestar, or firecracker star, whatever you call it. It doesn't have the rocket that I have doesn't have that explosion on it, meaning I can fly freely without being damaged. So that's a thing I actually have been doing while I was playing Minecraft, while my friend in the meantime, while I was just flying around while he was building stuff. So that's a thing. So I've been doing that for a long while now, so I'm quite used to it. And yes, puppy, quiet. Don't mind Fred, he's if you hear him, don't mind him. Yeah, his name is Fred, in case you were wondering. Yeah, his name is a legit Fred, so So the only way to do this safely, I'll show you exactly how it's done. Go to a high vantage point and then just fly down, or like somehow glide downwards, and have the fire and the firework rocket that doesn't have any shape or explosion on it. You can just use it, it's just the way it is. You make it, and it's pretty simple. You make the fire rocket, pretty simple. And I'll show you how that is done once I get close to the, when I get close to run out. The other thing is, well, it's out of saving here before I start flying here. But the thing is that the other thing is that I want to talk about is my friend of mine is actually hiding stuff throughout each map that he builds and giving me like a bit of a challenge to go and find all these items that are scattered. And you know what? It's a thing. To me, it's a thing. I love challenges. So, I mean, if you got one, give it to me. The other thing is that Luigi's Mansion, Dark Moon, is on hold for now until I find some way where I can continue on without having to change a few things. So enough with that. Now let's go ahead and continue on here. Alright, down we go. And yes, you can fly in water just by using rockets. It is a thing. It is a thing. Yes, it is a thing. Now, the last and final trial is just right to my left. Okay, you're wondering why I'm here. Here we go. The other thing is this. That my wings, pretty okay. Quite wild okay for a while. The thing I want to show you that you can really build is this. You bring up your, crafting menu. You don't have to have a crafting table for this. You go down to here. You can make your fire rocket or your firework star. That's what it is. Firework star. However, I don't want to make a firework star. So you can add a firework rocket. And as you can see, I have the ability of creating this, allowing me to have three extra with just one paper and gunpowder. That's it. The other thing is that you can select a banner, which I don't have one currently. You know, you can do so many things in Minecraft that you won't believe. Except for one thing that really, really, yeah, really made me really upset. This made me upset just by itself. The sticky pistons. If someone out there has a way to send an email or something to fix the bug, or whatever it is, somehow that you can push a block and a and pull it from right where it sits. But you can't push a piston facing the other direction with a block. And as when you push it, it doesn't take the blocks that are not pistons with it. It just removes it. It just stays in the same spot. I will eventually show you that in a sec so that you can see what I'm talking about. So hang on one second here. Okay? Now, it's bad and it really, really upsets me. It really does. Now I'm gonna grab the piston, however, a lever. And I'm gonna grab a random block. Okay? Now if it does what it wants here, then I'm pretty upset that it actually was in a different file. So, to be honest, I am not happy about the subject. So, the reason why I'm doing these is to show you why I am just legit upset. So I'm going to show you here before we start the trial. That's right there. That's in front of us, you can see. Now, look at this. I'm really upset about this. Watch. Look at this. It doesn't move the blocks. It just pushes the pistons, not with the blocks. If somebody can send an email about this, and as you're seeing this, send an email and the providers can fix this bug. I believe, in my opinion, this is a bug. So if you guys are watching this right now, do that email right now. I'm just not happy about the subject. But if there's already pistons in the game, those don't change. They're already there. Already. And they work. But if you place new ones, and they do this, they don't do nothing. They just don't move the block. It's so annoying. So if you're doing that email right now, thank you for helping me out on that. But if you're not seeing this, I feel sorry. So, enough of that now. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is this. Figure out a way to get inside this trial. And somehow this trial is pretty massive. So the only way to get inside, however, is very, very quite the mystery of how to get inside. Oh, wait, what? Hang on. Hang on. Oh, I see. I get it now. Do you see this? Right there. Do you see it? If not, right here. Right where the ladders are. It seems like that we have to go right over there. Let's see where this ladder goes. Remember, once you enter, you can't go back out. But in this trial, you can, since there's a way down or a way out. But in this trial is... telling you, something else. So, and this entire trial is just incredible. However, before we actually, in case you're wondering, I have the easy mode enabled. So meaning, there could be monsters upon this thing. And getting past this might be my downfall. So, hopefully I can get past it without a rendering issue. So, I'm hoping for the best. And if I fall off, I have my wings, so I'm able to fly down safely. So, I'm ready for this. I really am, to be honest. Yeah, I'm gonna be ready for this. Hang on. I'm gonna go to game options, change my game sensitivity to at least 120. The only reason why it's at 80% is so that I can fly easier and move around slower when I'm flying around. 120 just doesn't do very good for me flying. So when I'm actually flying, I'll pause the game, bring it down to 80%, and then start gliding that way. So it's easier for me to fly that way. So, with that out of the way, there might be some enough light up here that there might not be any monsters. But I don't want to get my hopes up in that case. In case there is monsters, I have a way. Crouch. There we go. I have a way, in some way, to defend myself. So I've got a sword and a bow. Let's equip the bow, or the sword, just in case, there's like one right here at the top of the stairs. Just in case. It does happen that way. Because you really don't want to be unprepared for no reason at all. Because if you're unprepared, you could potentially could die just instantly without being careless. So I want to make sure that I am, like, you know, prepared for this. Never know what monsters you can run into just without question. Okay, so there's some stairs right there. Let's go into them. Change the camera view. So you're going to see this quite a bit, is that the camera view is going to be changing quite a bit, so don't strain your eyes too much, because I'm going to be doing this quite a bit. Ah, cripes. Okay, as you can hear, right now, there's a zombie nearby. See what I mean? I want to make sure I'm really, really prepared for this. So how close am I to this thing? Oh, actually I'm going away from him. That's cool. Because his sound is a little... Alright, so I'm on this guy's shoulder. Now, here's the thing. Getting around this thing, or getting around his helmet, underneath his helmet, is the real problem. Without being attacked is the thing I don't want to be. See what I mean? Getting hit already. Okay, where's this thing at? Where's this guy at? He's somewhere. Where is he at? I hear him. Where is he at? I hear him. How the heck is he surviving if he's around? Yeah, he's somewhere. Where is he? I ain't worried about this fool. He has to be at least somewhere. Right now he's out of my sight, which is kind of nice. But what's really annoying, that he He is near. How can I say, is he near? That's not on that. That's strange. Huh. That is. That's strange. Okay, getting up this little arm thing. So somehow he was down there somewhere. He has to be, at least for the most part. So, with him out of the question for now, I am going to, damn, excuse me, I hear a skeleton nearby, where is it? Really? A skeleton nearby, where is it? Hang on, where is he at? I hear this fool. I don't see him anywhere suspicious. I don't see him in my sight. If I did, there's gotta be a way where I can actually attack this thing. But it sounds like... I don't hear him now. Whoa, that was strange. Was there for a minute, and now it's gone. Huh. Very, very strange. Wait, what? Hang on. Am I supposed to go this far? Hang on. Am I really supposed to go this far? There's gotta be something I'm really, really missing here. Is there, like, a stairway, or, like... Like, what the heck am I missing? There's gotta be something. So, I had to go up here a little bit further. Duh. Okay, now, be on the lookout here. Never know what could happen here. Okay, so it seems like it's lagging a little bit because there's a lot of fire going on. Well, ladies and gentlemen, oh, what is the red sand doing in here? What is the red sand doing in here? Red sand. Huh. Well, you know, you never know what it could be used for. You never know what it could be used for. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, that is the last and final trial. So, getting down is pretty easy because I've got the flight ability without a problem. So, hey, that's what's up, you know? Let's see. Well, I have enough to get down. That's for sure. Wouldn't that be annoying if I did not have enough to go down? I would have to do the painstaking task to go back down the ladder and just be done. But this time around, I made sure my flight is able for me to get down safely. Alright, so in order to do so, ladies and gentlemen, don't try this at home. Telling you, don't do this at home, because this, oh man, if you did this at home, telling you, it will be your last, I'm telling you. But if you know how to land, that's good. Anyway, so I landed safely, but we ain't done. We still have to take out the red coloring of the beacon here. That's the only thing left to do. So, placing it in the right spot will help our case here. ladies and gentlemen, this trial is officially complete. So, that is the trial right there. That's all you have to do, basically, is just go up the statue, collect your colored beacon, and you're done. And all you have to do, if you have the wings at that point, you can just fly right down and say, hey, guess what? I just did it all by myself. So, since we have like 4 minutes while we're at it, there's a couple things that I did off screen. I just want to show you some things that I did a little off screen. Just, an FYI. If I can remember where they're all at, that is. All the places that I actually did off screen by right off the bat. So, the only way to show you that is by flight. So, I'm gonna go to the highest vantage point because right now, right where I'm at, is not a good spot. So, I'm gonna go ahead and go up, try to find some more stairs to go up on. And hopefully there's no monsters on the way up. Because that would devastate me if I did find monsters. I think this is the majority of the highest I can go. Well, not really the highest I can go. Because right up there, like, no joke, that is pretty dang high. Just to go up that. Okay. But there's only one thing left to do on this entire region of this trial is go to the only location that was not revealed just yet. But I'll do that on the next episode. Since I don't have the time to do that, I have other things to worry about. There we go. Just get enough height. Alright, there's some things I do want to show you. That I did a little off screen so that you can see. As you can see, there is a brand new garden above, which is a good thing, because that actually helps me with some recipes offhand. Alright, so... Hey, ladies and gentlemen, say hi to Fred. This is my dog, Fred. Everyone say hi. That's Fred. This guy over here is Mr. Stew. What he does for me is that he gives me mushroom stew directly. Even though it's a cow, but it really is called mooshroom. It's actually what it's called. Yes, it is a thing that a cow's head that are that. Yes, it's a thing. I did, however, did a little fishing and I got quite a nice little surprising items, man. I mean, seriously. it's a thing. As you can see, I've got more wings than I thought I did. So, yeah, it's a thing. Anyhow, I don't know why I have a red. I am a black teen. Come on now. Red, get out of here. And yes, red is not a team on this map that my friend made for me. So, night vision potion. Oh, so I must have made that at some point. What do we have here? Wow, boat galore. Ha ha. not that. Oh, not sure what that's all about. But what's over here? I just went into that. All right. I'm sorry, but I want to show you guys this. I know it sounds weird for a cow to produce mushroom stew. Yes, it's a thing. I'll show you exactly and conclusively. Alright, so, even though it says right here at the bottom of the screen says milk, it really... You're getting a mushroom stew just right off the bat. Yeah, it sounds weird from a cow. But in Minecraft, it's possible. It's a thing, however, that if you see a cow with mushrooms on top, so that's why it's called mooshroom. It's a cow that's common. It's a cow that's hardly ever found on Minecraft. But I'll give you a hint. It's only found one location of the entire world itself. And I'll give you guys some time to think about that. You know, let's make this an extended episode while you guys think about what location mushrooms are found. Give me this egg. Give me it. Okay, fine. You had to put it over there, didn't you, Molly? Yeah, Molly is a new addition to this place. reason is that, I needed, some sort of animal that produces eggs every 5 minutes. So, that's what I wanted to do, so. Hey, part of the nature of the world. Okay, so we've got carrots, we've got, what is this? Wait, that's potato. Yeah, that's potato. Okay, so it looks like they are ready. If you're wondering where my hand is right now, I do have the setting set to no hand. So, if you guys came up with the idea of where mushrooms are found, it is not found on this entire map, in case you're wondering. Reason of that is that it's only one biome that is the mushroom is only found on. And that biome is none other than... what was it called? It's a biome that actually allows mushrooms to grow on. And it's a thing. There is a such biome of that. But I personally went through this entire map, and I can't distinguish one piece of land that I can think of right now that I can't say. things anyway. So, however, you can change the map a bit and make a nice little nifty small island that mushrooms can that can grow on if you don't have that particular biome. And if you make that little island, you potentially can make mushrooms back to back. And yes, it's a thing. I have done that several times. Telling you, it's a big thing for me. When it comes to Minecraft, however, I really look at the physics. Not the facts. When it comes to Minecraft, I'm telling you. Now we're gonna be sitting here for a little bit. So let's see, what can we talk about? Huh. Oh, you know what? I have a question for you guys. Which trial did you like the best out of this series? Leave your comments below. Tell me what you think. Let's start off answering the question. I personally, the best trial, I would say, to me, I would say it is the it's nearby. The one I really enjoy is the one that's nearby. Right here. The one I like, that I really enjoy, is this one right here. Based off on fire. And yes, I really did enjoy this. I really did, to be honest. And this is actually, to me, is the one of the best trials. I would have to say is the best. To me. Now, it's your turn to answer this question. What is the best trial you have seen so far? I want to hear them. I want to hear your answers. What is the best trial in this particular map itself, in this series, have you seen so far that you think is the best? I want to hear them. So, there's so many things in Minecraft you can literally do. Like, you can build your own home. You can build your home in underwater. You can build this. You can build that. I'm telling you, Minecraft, I don't know. It's something. I mean, I'm telling you, it's something. Minecraft is like a type of game that can get you surprised. I don't know what to say about it, really. So, I mean, to be honest, what could go wrong? Well, unfortunately, I have ran out of time. So again, I'm your host, SurvivalMan1, and if you really enjoyed this series, hit that subscribe button to help the channel grow, and also hit that bell notification button, or smack it, if you can, that is, if you know how to reach for it. But again, I'll catch you guys in the next episode of Minecraft GM.